This is a video on separation of variables, finding particular solutions. So I'm going to walk you through number 6, and then we'll go through number 8 real time. So I've got it color-coded up here. We're going to do separation of variables. So in order to separate the variables, I'm going to put the y's together on one side. So to do that, I've divided this side by y squared, which means I have to divide this side by y squared. In this case, I multiplied by 1 over y squared, same thing. And to get rid of this dt, I'm multiplying by dt on both sides. The result, on the left, 1 over y squared dy. On the right, 2t dt. Next, we integrate. Integrating each side, I've 2t becomes t squared plus c. I only need one constant. Then I have 1 over y squared, which is the same as y to the negative 2. I use power rule for antiderivatives here. And I've rewritten that as negative 1 over y. So after integrating, I get this equation. Negative 1 over y equals t squared plus c. I'm going to use my initial condition. So that's this information here. The input is negative 3. The output is negative 1 11th. So I'm inputting. Clearly, this is the output, so the input must be t. So I'm going to plug in negative 3 in for t. Again, that goes in here. So negative 3 squared plus c. And on the other side, I have negative 1 over y. My y is negative 1 11th. So the opposite of 1 divided by the opposite of 1 11th ends up being negative 1 times negative 11, or 11. Negative 3 squared plus c, subtract 9, and all of a sudden c is equal to 2. I plug in my 2, and then I go through the process of solving for y, and there's my particular solution. So let's check this out for a different equation, okay? I'm going to try to use the same colors here. So separation of variables, I'm actually going to rewrite the equation, dy over dt equals 2t over e to the y. I'm going to multiply by e to the y dt and multiply by e to the y dt. The reason being is I'm going to cancel the dt's over here. I'm going to cancel e to the y's over here. And the result is e to the y dy and 2t dt. Time to integrate. E to the y dy integrated will give us e to the y. 2t dt integrated will give me t squared plus c. Integration is done. Let's use our particular solution. In this case, it's 3, ln of 7. So it's e to the ln 7 equals 3 squared plus c. That's 9 plus c. The e to the ln of 7 is just 7. If we subtract 9, we get c is equal to negative 2. I'm going to rewrite this equation. E to the y is equal to t squared minus 2. How do I solve? How do I cancel e? I need an ln. And then the ln and e cancel. I get y equals the ln of t squared minus 2. Now, we also have to think about the domain of the ln function. This whole thing has to be greater than 0. So if t squared minus 2 has to be greater than 0, add 2, add 2. T squared is greater than 2. Square root both sides. And I'm not worried about the inequality portion of that being a compound inequality, because I'm not worried about the negatives here.